Hey guys, it's Miss Monique. I hope everybody's doing good. I'm doing awesome. Oh my goodness. I mean, God keeps showing his face, I'm telling you. And I don't know why. I'm so undeserving. But let me just tell you briefly, I had to do this video because God is so awesome in my life. Okay guys, so I probably won't pronounce it right, but it's called Goodlettsville, Tennessee. Somebody can correct me. And when I read the reviews, because I started reading reviews, they were all horrible, terrible. Oh my goodness. And you know I'm running on recaps, so I sent a message to my fleet manager. I'm like, am I being set up? Because all the reviews are horrible, and you know, I had 9 hours at the time, and I'm like, okay, all right, you know. So guys, I got there early. I got there last night, and there was no place to park. Now, I didn't go up to the gate because my appointment was today at 1 o'clock, between 1 and 2. It's the drop and hook, you know, my favorite. So I didn't do an arrival or anything. I just, once I talked to one of the guys, like a yard dog, I saw him coming down the street outside of, before you get to the guard shack. He was like, well, there's no parking here. And he said a lot of the truck drivers park, you know, and he told me where to go. So it was like a mile and a half away. So I just went there, stayed overnight, and then I went. Okay, now, today I get up to the booth. It's three young girls in the booth, and they're all so pleasant. Now, I don't know if, because when I go to the booth or anywhere, I'm always pleasant. Hey, how are you? Now, if they don't speak, I might get a little with them, or I might speak again. But at any rate, these girls were nice. And I told them it was my first time here, and then they gave me my instructions. Now, before I got there, somebody sent me a message on my Qualcomm letting me know the trailer number and that it was loaded. So I was like, oh, I should have had no problems when I go there. You know, you read the reviews and you do all of this. And so, guys, I get to the booth. Everybody's nice. And the young lady said, okay, fill this out. Go to the back, drop your trailer, then come back up here and pick up your trailer. Now, guys, I never take my purse off of the truck when I get to a shipper or receiver. What I do is I take my license, I have my vest, and I put my license in the pocket of my vest. Just in case some places ask for your license, I always want to have my license with me. And then I also, you know, I take my prime ID and, you know, an ink pen. But this time, I took my purse. So I got to the booth. I'm going to say I got to the booth. I'm just going to give an example. I was there early. My appointment was at 1 o'clock, and I think I got there at 12 o'clock or something like that. Just say I got there at 12. So I went to the back, dropped my trailer off, came back, you know, did all that. When I walked up to the guard's booth, y'all, my purse was sitting outside on the little check-in thing. This is where all the drivers sign in. Now, it's outside of the security booth, and it's a stand. So even the young ladies inside did not see my purse. You can't see it from inside. You have to be a driver, and you see a little table, and my purse was sitting there. God is so awesome, y'all. I'm gonna tell y'all, I was in there for at least an hour, okay? In there, you know, it's very tight in there too, y'all. To drop your trailer, I had to drop it just anywhere. They was like, just drop it anywhere. I was like, oh my gosh, I never heard of such blocking of a trailer. It was just a mess back there, but it's okay. So I walked up to the booth to turn my paperwork in and saw my purse there, y'all. Let me tell you, passport, license, social security card, just took money out the bank, all in my purse sitting up there. So when I got there, I was like, oh my goodness. I told the young lady, I was like, oh my gosh, I left my purse here. And she was like, what? She was like, we didn't even see it, because they can't see it from where they are. And I was like, God is so awesome. And then I just tried to tell, I started telling her, you know, I was reading the reviews before I got there, that this place was just totally opposite of what I had going on today. And, you know, she was very nice. They were very nice. They were very fast today. I don't know what happened today, but it was a good day. And God shined his light on me yet again. So I just wanted to come and get at this quick video, how despite what you have going on in your life, I'm telling you, God is simply amazing. So y'all be safe out there. Make safe choices. I'm on my way to Monroe, Georgia to Walmart. Talk to y'all later. Still running on these recaps, but I'm not going to ask for a 34 yet. Thank you so much, No Hippie, 1 Million Mile Man, JJ the Trucker, everybody who responded. Thank you so much for the help. Appreciate y'all. Bye.
It's like right now. It's like wow. It's like